Okay, good morning students. Today I would like to demonstrate the compound screw jack experiment. So see here, the same setup we used to conduct the simple screw jack experiment. So as you know, in that experiment, we don't keep nuts. I think here there is no nut and here also there is no nut. But here you can see here, we keep one nut here, just we lock this. Then it becomes a compound screw jack. Okay, so now here we see the compound screw jack. Two screws are moving in every revolution. So you can see here. Just I am showing. Here I am rotating. Here you see this is one screw. Here one screw. That means here two screws are moving. So that means it moves for one revolution, two pitch distance. But in the simple screw jack, in one revolution it moves, the load is moving upward, I think axially, one pitch distance. But in the compound screw jack, for the same one revolution, it moves two pitch distance. Okay, so now explaining, this is the load platform. So as you know, we keep the loads on here, and this is the effort hanger. We keep the effort here until the load platform moving. Okay, so now you should add this load base weight also to the load we keep on that, and we add the effort hanger weight to the effort of this is of 200 grams. The load base is of 500 grams. Okay, this is the observation table of our compound screw jack experiment. It is same as of your simple screw jack experiment. Here you see serial number, then load W, that is in grams. You add the load, you add the include weight of the load platform of 500 grams to the load which is you keep on the load platform. You add the hanger weight of 200 grams to the effort that is keeping on the effort hanger. So here this is velocity ratio. You will calculate the velocity ratio. Mechanical advantage, we know mechanical advantage is equal to load by effort W by P. Then efficiency, we are going to calculate the efficiency here, that is equal to mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. So now here we have two screws. Already you have seen now, just now. These two screws are of same pitch of 2.5 mm. Now this is the formula to calculate the velocity ratio. So velocity ratio V are equal to distance moved by the effort hanger by the distance moved by the load. Okay, now I am going to calculate the distance moved by the load. Distance moved by the load equal to number of revolutions into pitch of the screws. Okay, here I am conducting or I am calculating the velocity ratio by revolving two revolutions. So that is the reason I am taking two revolutions. Then here we have two screws. Already you have seen now. So then two screws into pitch of each screw is 2.5. Then it becomes 2 into 2 into 2.5. So then that is 10 mm. Okay. So now we need this value, that is distance moved by the effort, and we can measure this value at the experiment setup, how much distance the effort hanger is moving when you complete two revolutions of the load base by using the tape. And simultaneously I am going to conduct the experiment by keeping the load on the load platform, and at which effort value the load handle just moving, I am noting down that value here, and then simultaneously I will calculate the velocity ratio, mechanical advantage and efficiency. Okay, now I am going to find the how much distance moved by the effort in two revolutions to calculate the velocity ratio. So initially I am measuring the distance of the effort hanger from the floor, so that is at a distance of 620 mm. Okay, I'm not on the 620 mm. So now I'm rotating this load base 2 revolutions. Okay, so okay, so 1 revolution it is completed now. Now okay, now I completed 2 revolutions. Now I'm measuring the distance of the effort hanger from the floor. Okay, okay, then that is at a, that is 45 mm. Okay, 45. So I'm subtracting the 45 from 620. So then I get the value of how much distance moved by the effort hanger in 2 revolutions, that is 575 mm. So now I am conducting the experiment by keeping the weight of 2000 grams on load base. Okay, so initially I want to round it. Okay, right, I'm keeping the weight of 2000 grams here. So now that is the weight to be lifted by this compound screw jack. Now I'm keeping the 200 grams on the effort hanger. Okay, it is moving. So next I am noted on the value of effort, that is of 200, plus I am adding the weight of the effort hanger, that is 200. Similarly for a load also I am adding weight of the load platform of 500 to the load that is to be kept, that is of 2000. Okay, we got the values of load and effort from the experiment. So the load value, that is of 2000. So I am adding the weight of the load platform, that is of 500. So the total is 2500 grams of load W. And the effort, I kept 200 grams on the effort hanger, and I'm including the hanger weight of 200. So then it becomes 400 grams. Now I am calculating the velocity ratio. So anyway, we know velocity ratio equal distance moved by the effort by distance moved by the load. We know distance moved by the load is 10 mm. So now we got the value of distance moved by the effort from the experiment. So that is of 575 mm. Now I'm substituting here in this velocity ratio formula. So that is the distance moved by the effort is 575. Distance moved by the load is 10 mm. So then it is 57.5. So now the velocity ratio is 57.5. So I am going to calculate the mechanical advantage. The formula is load by effort W by P. Here the load is 2500 by effort, that is 400. So now I'm calculating. So 2500 by 400. So that is 6.25. So now I'm going to calculate the efficiency. Efficiency equal mechanical advantage by velocity ratio. Here mechanical advantage is 6.25 by velocity ratio 57.5. 6.25 divided by 57.5, so 0.11. So then So 11%. So here we know from the simple screw jack, the efficiency, compare with that efficiency, here we get more efficiency, almost double that. Earlier we got 5%, here now we get 11%, more than 2%, more than double. So that is the advantage of compound screw jack and using two screws here. Thank you.